kakosh kalabala kete bara regado shakat halabala kete bara ude regado shakat ha.
The Spirit of the Living God that is present in the church is holy, and the body of Christ is holy. So because a spirit that is holy is in the church, then the church is holy. The Christian body is holy because it is the place where God dwells by his Spirit, which is holy. In Romans chapter 1 verse 4, Romans chapter 1 verse 4, it says, "And declare to be the Son of God with power, according to the Spirit of holiness, by the resurrection from the dead." So the Spirit that is present in you as a believer is the Spirit of holiness. The Spirit of holiness represents the Holy Spirit. So you are the holiness of God because the Spirit of holiness dwells in you. Listen to me and get this clearly. You are the holiness of God because the Spirit that is holy dwells in you. The Spirit which is holy cannot dwell in a body that is not holy. The Spirit which is holy cannot dwell in an unclean body. So that means the body of Christ is a clean body. It's a pure body, holy body, because the Spirit which is holy is in the church. In Romans chapter 5 verse 5, it says, "And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost which is given unto us." The love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, the Ghost which is holy, the Spirit which is holy, which is given unto us. We have that Holy Ghost in us, and that is why we can manifest the love of God. So without holiness, no man can manifest the love of God. And we can live that life of holiness and righteousness by the Spirit which is holy, which has been given to the church. A Spirit which is holy has been given unto the church, and this Spirit will help us to live a holy life, a righteous life, and demonstrate the agape love of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19 says, "What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own?" Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. So the body of Christ is the temple of the Holy Ghost. And that body of Christ is the church of God. So every believer is a spiritual temple on earth, carrying a divine spirit on earth. Every believer is a spiritual temple. We are temples on earth. We are spiritual temple. And because we carry the Spirit of God, every believer is carrying a spiritual atmosphere on earth. There is a spiritual atmosphere you carry on earth because the Spirit of God is in you, and this Spirit will impact and input in you. Listen to me. This Spirit will impact onto you and input in you a particular dimension of the spiritual gift of God, and you are to manifest that spiritual gift on earth. So every believer is carrying a spiritual atmosphere. There is a spiritual atmosphere you carry inside of you, and you can easily manifest that spiritual atmosphere. We are the living temple. We are the walking temples on earth because the Spirit of God is present in us. You have the Spirit in you. You are a temple. The temple is not just a living temple or living altar. Every believer is a living altar. The altar is spiritual, not physical. Every believer is a living temple. Every believer is a living altar. And every believer is a living pulpit. So the altar, the pulpit, the temple is not something that is just physical. It is something that is spiritual. So in the old dispensation, we have symbols and pictures of temples and altars which represent the current dispensation church. So the current generation church is the spiritual temple of God where the Spirit of God dwells. So in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verses, it says, by pureness, by knowledge, by long suffering, by kindness, by the Holy Ghost, by love unfeigned, by love unpolluted, undiluted, the agape love of God, not the human love, not the filial love, not the erotic love or the romantic love, by the agape love of God, by the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost is holy. The Spirit of God is holy. And that Spirit which is holy is in the church. So the body of Christ is also holy because we carry the Holy Spirit. We are the walking temple of God on it. The walking tabernacle of God on it. The walking altar of God on it. The walking pulpit of God on it. Because we have the Spirit of God in us. And your understanding of this will determine how you will relate with your fellow believers. It will determine how you will relate with your fellow believer and be blessed with the atmosphere they carry in this physical realm. Hallelujah.